And we'll start with Gunpowder, because that's the big, I think that's the big one, isn't it?
Okay. Start with the Big Bang.
although, again, a drama that's called Gunpowder that didn't have any gunpowder in it.
That's got 3 episodes, give it time.
Yeah, which are, interestingly, all available on the iPlayer. Basically, this is set as soon as Elizabeth I dies and James I comes into power.
I love that. Elizabeth I.
Elizabeth I and James I. Basically, he hires all these like ruffians to go round to all the sort of Catholic households, because they're all sort of Protestants, aren't they?
Yes.
And try and find the priests who are plotting in... is it Flanders they're plotting?
Yes, that's right. Yes, that's quite a famous
plotting
thing.
Plotting in Flanders to sort of overthrow the king. And there's people like is it Robert Catesby, who's a sort of devout Catholic, and his family in early on are hiding sort of young priests and an old priest played by Peter Mullen in their house in various like little nooks and crannies as scenery chewing Sean Dooley appears and wrecks the house in search of any sort of heretics that he might find. This episode is sort of basically setting up why the gunpowder plot happened.
Yeah. It's more the background, it's more the why they did it rather than the how they did it.
Yeah, because you've got Derek Riddell from The Missing is playing King James the First as a very sort of, almost like a flippant leader, isn't he? He's very sort of joyous.
Very privileged and laissez-faire about his responsibilities.
Oh, nice.
Thank you.
And he's got working for him several people who are sort of competing in a chewing the scenery competition. We've got Sean Dooley and Mark Gatiss, who are both sort of eating at whatever corners they can find, I think. I found this quite underwhelming, actually, I have to say, to get my cards on the table. I found it moved at quite a slow pace to start off with, and there was a lot of stuff about sort of religious order and courts and things, and... I never thought it didn't have that, again, pun intended, that bang that I felt it needed. The most sort of memorable scene is where his mum gets tortured and killed.
And hung, drawn and quartered to the priest. The priest was hung, drawn and quartered.
At 9:30 on a Saturday night on BBC One. I couldn't believe it.
Well, there was quite a bit of backlash, and people did say it was overly violent.
Oh, wasn't there?
But of course, well, yeah, there was a bit of Twitter storm and a few complaints I read about. But to be fair, this was the time. You know, this was the 1600s, 1700s. This is what happened.
So 1600s, you got it right the first time.
1600s, right. Therefore, the 17th century, as I was going to say. This is how they killed people in those days. They didn't, you know, put them in prison. They lopped their heads off or tortured them. I did think they went a bit overboard with the whole, you know, showing how she was killed by putting these kind of heavy weights on her and crushing her.
I don't think we need to see her naked, really, either.
Well, you did and you didn't. It was kind of enough in the distance. But, you know, yeah, he's right. But I mean...
I think you saw it quite prominently.
You saw a prominence. There wasn't a lot of action. I quite liked this. I must admit, I found it strange that it was on Saturday night. I didn't mind the violence. The one thing to say as well is that Kit Harington is not only related to the character he's playing, I believe, but he has written and produced this. I thought I saw his name next to written, but I could be wrong, so I won't.
It said co-create. No, it's been written by Ronan Bennett, who did Hot Boy. Certainly co-created by Kit Harington.
Co-created. And I know he was one of the producers as well, because I saw him on the One Show when he was on a couple of weeks ago, and he said
he's an executive producer. Yeah.
He said he found it very difficult acting and producing, and he probably wouldn't do that again. I quite liked it. I don't want to watch it on the iPlayer. I'm quite happy to watch it either on Saturday night or, you know, when I record it.
I know we've mentioned this in the past, but I just don't think BBC knows quite what to put on the iPlayer and what not to. Yeah. I think they should have put Relic on the iPlayer, personally.
Yeah.
Because then more people would have watched it. Someone might have watched it.
Gunpowder,
I can sort of understand why this was on there to an extent, because it's a three-parter. It's a it's a one-story thing, so it does make sense to an extent. But yeah, I won't be watching the rest of this.
Okay.
It's just not for me. And
Fair enough.
I think Luke feels the same.